What's up, you guys? It's Cassidy. Welcome back to my channel. Do you guys ever get annoyed of me saying the same stuff over and over again? Today, I am doing a yearly favorites. I'm gonna be talking about my favorite items of 2017. I can't believe 2017 is already a year that's behind us. Like, we are in 2018. 2017 was a year that I put in a lot of hard work into, and I learned so much about myself this year. So it was definitely one of like those years where you lay your foundation down for your future. It was that year that I learned to work hard like I've never done before. 2017 kind of taught me like, okay, I am capable of doing things that I never thought I was capable of doing. Would you look at that? I'm so excited for this new year ahead. I feel like now things are just gonna come to fruition, and I'm over the moon. I'm so excited. Before we get into this video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give this video a big thumbs up. Click the like button down below. It really helps me out, and I love when you guys do that. So I'm not gonna be too like in order too much. I'm gonna try to go by order of how I do my makeup, but I'm not being too specific with this video. I'm just gonna talk about the crap that I love, and I hope you guys like it. I'm first gonna talk about my all-time favorite skin primer that I found this year, and oh my gosh, you guys, I am so excited about this product. This is the Rich Priming Moisturizer by Glossier. And this was actually the first year that I tried a lot of things from Glossier, and the brand as a whole is just so cool, so amazing. I just feel like they're a very positive and unique makeup brand, so the fact that I found this and that I actually love it as much as I do makes me so happy. So it's basically a moisturizer. It's a very, very thick moisturizer. It doesn't feel sticky though. It's just extremely nourishing to your skin. It has a very luxurious feel to it, and with my dry skin, this thing is a lifesaver because it just really primes my skin and gets my skin ready to have makeup on it, but it also really moisturizes my skin at the same time. I'm sure you guys recognize it because I use it almost every time I do my makeup on camera and off of camera as well. So this has been my go-to primer. Now for foundations, I feel like you guys are definitely not going to be surprised by this, and they are these two foundations by L'Oreal. L'Oreal just killed it with these foundations. Like, I am obsessed with the both of these. So for my skin type, I like to mix the both of these. I just feel like it gets me the perfect full coverage, natural finish, and I'm obsessed. So the first one, this is the Infallible Pro Matte Foundation, and then we have the Infallible Pro Glow Foundation. So if you have really, really, really dry skin, the Pro Glow is amazing, and if you have really oily skin, the Pro Matte is also amazing. This one is like super, 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 super duper matte, like very matte, but it does not make your skin look cakey at all. Like, for my skin, it's a little bit too matte, which is why I love mixing the Pro Glow within to these. These two together are my perfect balance. They just, it's like right in the middle, right in between, not too matte but not too dewy. So having these together, I have like tons of bottles of these because I literally use it so much that I'm always like having to pick up new ones. I've ran through about 3 bottles of these already. So yeah, this year, this foundation, we've been having a constant relationship. I'm committed to these two foundations and to mixing them together and just having this love affair because they're amazing. And not to mention, they are freaking super affordable, which is also really great. Now for concealers. Okay, so concealers are my, I don't know if you guys know this about me, but concealer is my favorite part about makeup. Concealing and highlighting, like the under eye area, it's my favorite part of doing my makeup. So I have 3 concealers here. The first one is the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer. I love, love, love this concealer. You'll notice in all the concealers that I mentioned, they have somewhat of a dewy finish. I don't like matte concealers. I don't like concealers that are drying on your skin. It's just not my deal, and I don't know, my skin just doesn't look good with concealers like that. So this one, the Naked Skin one, is so good because it still still leaves a dewy finish on your face, but it's also full coverage and it's just really, really comfortable on the skin. Another two that I found this year, and that these are actually completely empty because I use them. The first one is the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer. When I first started my YouTube channel, I used to use this one nonstop, and I still feel the same way about it. Like, I need to go back and repurchase it because it's just so good. It leaves you looking glowy. It has a very like luminous finish, but you can set it down with a powder if you want it to be more matte, and it still looks beautiful. It just, every time I wear this, I look very youthful and bright, and my skin just looks so healthy, and I love that. And honestly, I have the same things to say about this one. This is the Revlon Youth Effects Fill and Blur Concealer. And these actually remind me, like the finishes remind me a lot of each other. I would just say that this one does cover my under eyes, but I think this one is just a little bit more full coverage than this one is. It's not like this one is sheer or anything, but I just feel like this one has a little bit more of a natural finish than the other ones. But I still love it just as much. It still leaves me looking very youthful, very dewy, and just like healthy, like a very healthy, glowing look to my skin. So that's why I love all three of these. And this year I have ran through them like nobody's business. They are amazing. Now for powder, I have still only used one powder, and I think this has not changed from last year. I'm pretty sure I mentioned this powder as my favorite last year as well, and it is the RCMA No Color Powder. It's just really the only one I use, and maybe I need to branch out a little bit, but I'm so picky with powders because my skin tends to get really dry, obviously, and it just, I don't know, like, I feel like I just have a hard time finding powders, so I always just stick to this one, and this year nothing has changed. I've been using this every single time I do my makeup. This is the one that I use. I use it to bake, I use it to set my whole face, and it's just my favorite. If you guys have any other powder suggestions, please leave them down below, because I have the absolute hardest time finding powders. Now I'm gonna go through bronzer, blush, and highlight. The one bronzer that I have to mention, and I'm sure you guys saw this coming, is the BH Cosmetics Satin Bronzer. This is in the shade Totally Tan, and oh my gosh, you guys. I found this bronzer this year, and it is my all-time favorite bronzer. I have it on right now, and I also wear it every single day because it's just so amazing. Like, this is the one bronzer that I am completely obsessed with. I have zero complaints about it. The only thing I will say is I am already very fair, but if you are more fair than I am, this might be a little bit too orange on you. But surprisingly, when I saw it in the pan, I didn't think it would work for me because I thought that it was gonna be way too orange. But when it's on my skin, it just gives me the most beautiful bronzed, sun-kissed, glowing look, and I am truly, truly obsessed with this powder. So this is my favorite of the entire year. So I have two blushes that I fell completely in love with this year, and surprisingly, they are both matte blushes. Usually I like blushes with a little bit more of a shimmer in them, but these are just so beautiful. I couldn't help myself but use them this year. So this first one is by Flower Beauty, and it is in the shade Peach Primrose. And I was using this so much in a lot of my makeup tutorials in like the beginning and the middle of this year. It's just like a very nice, pretty, peachy coral color. And I love the formula of it as well. I also love how it's like not too pigmented, how it goes on my skin. It just always picks up the right amount. Even if I'm a little bit heavy-handed, I can just go right in and it never looks like too much on my face. And then the next one we have, which I've been using more recently, is the Sleek Blush in the shade Coral, and it's this beautiful, again, it's just a really, these are my kind of blush colors, that corally, peachy tone. I'm absolutely obsessed with colors like these, so this one I've also been using to give my Flower Beauty one a little break. I've been using this one and I've been loving it. This one has more of a pigmented, brighter tone than the Flower Beauty one, but these are my favorites of the entire year. Next up, I have one special little highlight. I'm so happy about this because I always thought that this one wasn't gonna work for me, and it is the Laura Geller Gilded Honey Highlight. I heard everyone talking about it, and I convince myself that this just would never work for me, just because when it's in the pan, it looks like it's super gold. Like, I thought it was gonna be a very, very gold color, and for my fair skin, I just was like, there's no way that's working for me. But once I actually gave it a chance and tried it out, I put it on my skin and I was like, what? Why have I been waiting so long to use this? Because I have it on right now, and it does have a gold undertone, but it kind of shows up as a little bit of a champagne color more than like a true yellowish gold color. I love how it goes onto my skin. It's very buildable. The formula is amazing. Every time I have this on, I always get asked in my photos, what highlight are you wearing? Because it's just so like glowing. It's so shimmery and just beautiful. It is my all-time favorite one of the entire year. Then we have my favorite setting spray of the entire year. This is by Pure Cosmetics, and it is the Miracle Mist Hydrating Spray. It is freaking bomb, and I feel like I haven't heard anyone talking about this setting spray, and I just think it's so amazing. It's my favorite one of the entire year. It has a very refreshing, lemony, citrus scent, so every time I spray it, I just feel like so, like, refreshed. If I put a little bit too much powder on, or I just don't really like how the powder is looking on my face, I go in with this and it completely like perfects my makeup. It makes my makeup look so good, and it makes me look really hydrated, which is a thing that I struggle with. So I am completely obsessed with this. Now I'm going to jump in and talk about some lip products, because there were tons of lippies that I fell in love with this year. So the first ones that I have to give a shout out to are these Tarte Rainforest of the Sea lipsticks. First of all, the packaging obviously is so freaking adorable. It is this light blue marble with like some white streaks in it. And then the colors that I've been using nonstop this year are 1 Skinny Dip, 2 Surfs Up, and Pink Lemonade. So these three have been my go-tos. I must say Skinny Dip is the one that I've used the most. Like, this is my go-to nude lip color. I'll put on like a mauve-y lip liner, and then I will go in with this lipstick, and it is my perfect nude lip. I'm obsessed with this thing. I'm sure you guys have noticed, but I use this lipstick almost every single day. And then we have Surfs Up, which is a little bit more of a dark mauve-y color, which I love as well. Not for every day, but I definitely love this when I don't want just like a blank nude color, but I still want to stick with my neutral family. Next we have Pink Lemonade, and this one is similar to Surfs Up. It just has a little bit more of a pinky peachy tone to it, and I love this just as equal. These lipsticks are so good. They are super creamy and not drying at all. So I really love that. Sometimes I don't want a liquid lipstick that's gonna like dry my lips out and last for the whole day. Sometimes I just wanna throw on a lipstick that's gonna be creamy but still be very pigmented, and that's what these give me. They're amazing. They're so good. I swear, if you guys have not tried these, you need to. Then I have one gloss that I just couldn't go without mentioning this one, because, oh my god, I love this one so much. This is by Flower Beauty, and it is their gloss in the shade Classic Nude. I've been using this so much. If I want a nude gloss, I always throw this one over the Tarte Skinny Dip lipstick just to create that gorgeous, drop-dead gorgeous, like very glossy, pigmented nude lip. It makes my lips look so luscious and just beautiful. Like, I love this lip color. If I have a nude gloss on in any of my videos, chances are this is the one that I'm wearing. Now, for sort of like eye finishers, mascara and liner. The first one that hands down is the best liquid liner I've ever tried is Schwing Liner by The Balm. It's so good. I wear it in almost every video, every day. I've been wearing this for a long time now. It is such an intense black liner. So my suggestion is, if you're just starting out doing liquid liner, this is not the liner for you. I think you need to be a pro to use this liner, because if you mess up with this one, it's really it's not hard to take off, but it's gonna, like, you're gonna have to wipe everything off all at once. So, because the intensity of it is so black, and I love it for my makeup looks when I wanna take pictures, it just disguises itself, like, into my eye, since it's such a deep, dark black color. It is my favorite liquid liner of the entire year. And then for mascara, I must say that this year, L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise definitely blew me out of the water this year. As soon as I tried this mascara, I was like, oh my god, I know I'm gonna love this one. And I used it for a really, really long time. The wand is just so thick and full, and that's exactly how it makes your lashes look. It makes your lashes look really full, very voluminous, and I love that it just adds a lot of volume to my lashes. It's an amazing mascara. I was using it a ton this entire year, and I've really, really been obsessed with it. But this one finished on me just in time for me to find a new one, which I found recently, but I'm still just as in love with this. And this is the Maybelline Total Temptation Mascara. It's just as good as the L'Oreal Lash Paradise. It just has a different shaped wand. This one is just like a thick wand. It has a little bit of a twist to it, but they both have sort of that same concept of adding a lot of volume to your lashes. And then the last thing that I will talk about are two palettes that I completely fell in love with and used so much this year. And the first one is the Nude Beach Palette by The Balm. I was using this literally for almost every look where I wanted to wear eyeshadow. It's such a gorgeous palette. I love that on this side you have your basic warm neutrals that you would ever need for any eyeshadow look. And then over here you could play with color a little bit with like some cranberries, some deep purples. It's so, so beautiful. I use this for any time that I traveled. I only brought this one and I would be good to go. I got so much use out of it this year that I just really, really recommend this palette to anyone who is looking for a good neutral palette but still wants some color. This thing is so, so amazing. And my second eyeshadow palette love this year is the Pixie by It's Judy Time palette. This one is also so amazing. Like, look at all of these beautiful neutral tones. Anytime I wanted to have transitions, if I wanted a simple look, if I wanted a dramatic look, this was a palette that I would go to as well. It's so good. It has just enough matte shades and just enough shimmery shades for you to get a really, really beautiful eyeshadow look. And the quality of the eyeshadows is also amazing. They blend effortlessly, like literally effortlessly. They're so amazing. And I just think Judy and Pixie did such an amazing job on this. And these have been my two most used palettes for the entire year. That was it for this favorites video. I hope you guys enjoyed my favorites for the entire year. Please comment down below and let me know if you guys found any of these products or if you used any of them. I would love to know. But I'm just so happy to be completing this year with you guys. You guys helped me reach my goal of 10,000 subscribers, and it just makes me so happy. So stay tuned for my next giveaway, because that's gonna be full of makeup and I'm so excited to do that with you guys. And yeah, I just wanna thank you all for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe, because you know how much it means to me from the very bottom of my heart. I love you guys so, so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.